Well, quantum mechanics tells us how the world works when we look at, you know, really tiny things like atoms and electrons and things like that. The transistors inside your cell phone or your computer are so small that we really are starting to see quantum mechanics happen there. So the classic laws of electronics, those are starting to break down just because the devices are so small. It's a great time to be, you know, studying quantum mechanics because the technology is letting us do some things we've never been able to do before.
Quantum mechanics is endemic in the way your cell phone works, in the way your computer works. More than that, it's just the fundamental question of who we are and how we come to be, because this is how the universe behaves on some fundamental level.
Everything now that has a chip is based on those principles of quantum mechanics. The way we got to where we are right now is by understanding and then optimizing how those semiconductors work so that now they fit in your pocket. And that was the first quantum revolution. The second quantum revolution, the way we think about it, is now how do we manipulate those principles themselves.
These days, we sort of turn the world around. We say that matter is fundamentally quantum. I take an atom, I take an electron, that's a quantum object. And now I want to build matter back up from the bottom with nanotechnology. I want to build something practical, like a computer. What quantum computing does and what quantum cryptography does is to harness the strangest and most fundamental laws we understand about how nature works to change the rules of what the machine is, and therefore to change the rules of what's a hard problem and what is something you give up on because it's impossible and what is something you can grasp. And that's in medicine, that's in chemistry, where people say, here's a molecule, it should do something, or here's your DNA, it should do something. But there are too many degrees of freedom.
It's going to be, again, another paradigm shift in terms of how we control the world around us. So that's one aspect of it. The other, I think, is quantum communication. Communication that's completely secure and that influences everything else, that will be banking, quantum money, transactions, secrets, governments, defense. It's kind of like when humanity stepped in the space age, it's like it's just not scientists or engineers, it's the public. Like, this is kind of the quantum frontier from a different perspective. It's this collective breath that humanity is holding to see, like, what's going to be next. And it's us saying that, oh my God, we're going to see it happen. Only great things can come out of it. And it would be great if those great things come from Pittsburgh.
So 4 years ago, we started this quantum initiative, and very early on, we realized that it really can't just be a Pitt-only institute.
This is an alliance of faculty members from different departments and different schools who feel strongly enough that they could benefit from building a community.
So I did my undergrad at Pitt and had a great experience there, and then I did graduate work at Carnegie Mellon, and so I've seen what both of these universities have to offer. If those people can come together, they could do everything from start to finish, and next thing you know, you've got some new technology.
The way that PQI helps to connect the engineers with the fundamental, you know, physicists is really important to me, because my expertise is not in quantum phenomena. My main objective is to create next generation devices, so devices that are going to be found in your smartphones and your computers a few decades from now. And so if we can build these off out of materials that are single molecule thick, we're looking at building devices at the ultimate limit of scaling that do not consume much energy.
One of the promises of quantum mechanics is energy efficient computing. It turns out that there's all sorts of new emerging phenomena in quantum mechanics. And so we're looking at ways we can leverage that to build, develop new materials and build new devices. And having a mix of people who work in material science with people who work in physics, who work in electrical engineering, we can have that complete group to really make things happen.
So right now, the purpose of PQI, as I see it, is to foster communication between different faculty members and, you know, bring students in. Collaboration is extremely important because the type of science that I do is just the first step.
You want people to have to walk by each other and interact. And you want people to hear the screams of joy and to run over and figure out what the new ideas are and contribute and just form this sort of virtual cycle where people feed off each other and inspire each other. And Pittsburgh, outside of these universities, right, has a great environment in terms of still being a place where people know how to make stuff and being a place where people are reinvesting and making the next generation of, you know, objects and ways of communicating and ways of transporting ourselves. And then, you know, when that starts to become every day, when you take your driverless car to work, then we will be there with the quantum technology that fuels the next stage.
So I was born and raised in Pittsburgh, and so I have a great fondness in my heart for Pittsburgh. And I believe that studying quantum phenomena certainly fits in. I think Pittsburgh is just the perfect place for that.
It's a city of resilience. It has grown back from steel to artificial intelligence, cancer treatment, moon robots. I think Pittsburgh can do the quantum thing too.
It's really the intellectual environment that exists in Pittsburgh that is really going to be essential for PQI, in my opinion. You need to have more creativity, people who are not afraid to follow an idea and see where it goes. We have a running start. We have great, young, ambitious researchers who know what they need to do. The challenge of the second quantum revolution is really what PQI is all about, using the resources from Pittsburgh to develop technologies, to develop understanding. Quantum mechanics is at the heart of everything that we know and we understand. And being able to control quantum mechanics is going to really profoundly change society in ways that we really only dimly imagine at this point.